day to everyone. Today, our message would be related to the super typhoon. We will be connect this super typhoon to one of the problem, since every typhoon is considered a problem, and this super typhoon is actually considered as one of the problem when it comes to Christianity. Spiritually speaking, the problem of opinion, like a super typhoon. In Matthew chapter 16 verse 21 to 26, it says here, "From then on, Jesus began to tell his disciples plainly that it was necessary for him to go to Jerusalem, and that he would suffer many terrible things at the hands of the elders, the leading priests, and the teachers of the law," or the teachers of religious law. "He would be killed, but on the third day, he would be raised from the dead." "But Peter took him aside and began to reprimand him for saying such things. 'Heaven forbid, Lord,' he said, 'this will never happen to you.'" Verse 23, "Jesus turned to Peter and said, 'Get away from me, Satan. You are a dangerous trap to me. You are seeing things merely from a human point of view, not from God's.' Then Jesus said to his disciples, 'If any of you wants to be my follower, you must turn from your selfish ways, take up your cross, and follow me. If you try to hang on to your life, you will lose it. But if you give up your life for my sake, you will save it.'" Verse 26, "And what do you benefit if you gain the whole world but lose your own soul? Is anything worth more than your soul?" The word of the Lord. In this verse, we will point out four things with regards to that problem of opinion. It was from the conversation between the Lord and the Peter. In verse 22, we can see the opinion. Verse 23, we can see the word that comes from the Lord, Satan. In verse 24, there is the message pointing to the self. And verse 25 and 26, it talks about the soul life. This position of Peter is clearly seen in the passages that we have just read. Although the word disposition is not mentioned in those verses, it can be seen in the elements of opinion, in the elements of the self, in the elements of the soul life, and in the element of Satan. Satan is in our opinion. That's the truth. And our opinion comes from ourself. It is the product of our disposition. Without opinion, there would be no such thing as disposition. A person's disposition is seen in his opinion. Marami po tayong makikita sa bawat sitwasyon, sa bawat areas, na ang isang tao ay nagpapakita ng sarili niyang opinion. And that opinion, actually, pointing to himself. Ginagawa natin yan, o sinasabi natin na yan ay ang ating disposition. In marriage life, for example, the sin of ambition does not arise every day, but the problem of opinion may arise many times sa loob lamang ng isang araw. Maaring hindi nyo pag-aawayan, o maaring hindi pinag-aawayan yung mga ambisyon ng bawat miyembro ng pamilya o sa mag-asawa. Pero ang madalas na pinag-aawayan ng mag-asawa ay yung opinion ng bawat isa. At hindi lamang po isang beses sa loob ng isang araw. May mga pagkakataon pa, there are times na sa bawat araw, napakaraming pagtatalo ng mag-asawa patungkol lamang sa opinion. sa simbahan, in the church life, at sa ating tinatawag na spiritual life. Yan, opinion din yan, ang siyang tinatawag nating greatest damaging factor. Our usefulness before the Lord depends greatly on the matter of our opinion. Kapag masyado kang ma-opinion, maaring hindi ka gamitin ng Panginoon. Maaring puro rebuke ang mga ang matatanggap mo. Kasi ang dami mong opinion. Para kasing ang lumalabas, yung opinion natin, ang madalas na ini-insist natin na gustong aprubahan ng Diyos. Well, we Christians should know that in our Christian journey, be careful with our opinion. Pag ikaw ay masyadong ma-insist sa iyong opinion, the less you can be used by the Lord. Hindi ka magagamit ng Panginoon kapag masyado kang maraming opinion. In Matthew chapter 16 verse 21, the Lord Jesus told His disciples that He was about to be crucified. But here, we can see that Peter began to rebuke. Imagine Peter, the disciple of the Lord, he rebuked Jesus and he said, God, be merciful to you, Lord. This shall by no means happen to you. Hindi raw mangyayari. Ayaw niya mangyayari. Pagpunta ni Jesus sa Jerusalem ay magiging dahilan ng kanyang kamatayan. But it was the Lord Jesus who told this to His disciples that He need to suffer and on the third day, He will be resurrected. But Peter said in verse 22, God be merciful to you, Lord. This shall by no means happen to you. And that is what we call Peter's opinion. In this conversation of Peter with the Lord Jesus, hayagan na sinalungat ni Peter ang Panginoon. Ang sabi niya, this shall by no means happen to you. Parang sinasabi ni Peter na, Panginoon, hindi ka dapat mamatay. Panginoon, hindi dapat kami maligtas. Panginoon, hindi dapat kami magkaroon ng resurrection. Panginoon, hindi ka dapat mamatay, hindi ka dapat maghirap. Hindi ka dapat maghirap, hindi ka dapat mamatay at hindi ka dapat mailibing at hindi ka dapat mabuhay na maguli. Parang ganyan yung sinasabi ni Peter. That was Peter's opinion. Sa side ng Panginoon, si Peter was like a mask hiding the source of the opinion. Ibig sabihin, nakamaskara si Peter during that time. The source was not Peter actually. The source was Satan. And then the Lord turned to Peter and said, get behind me, Satan. Opinion is a great and terrible problem. It frustrates the Lord's way o yung tinatawag nating pamamaraan ng Diyos. Great and terrible problem ay ang ating opinion. It frustrates God's way. It frustrates God's will, His plan, and even His economy to us, to our family, to our church, to our workplace. The factors causing the storms were ambition and opinion. Yan ang nagiging dahilan bakit meron tayong tinatawag na bagyo ng buhay. Literally speaking, a typhoon is a storm that is associated with hot climates. Associated daw yan ng mainit na connected yan. A typhoon is a storm that is associated with hot climates. We should not be bothered by the storms. Hindi ka dapat mag-alala kapag may mga bagyo ng buhay ay dumarating sa iyo. No storm comes that will not go away quickly. And the bigger storms pass even more quickly. Sa kabila ng bagyo ay tinatawag na super bagyo or super typhoon. ang typhoon ay dumarating sa atin at hindi yan nagtatagal. Mas lalo na yung tinatawag na super typhoon. Mas mabilis ang pagdating, mas mabilis ang pag-alis. Even the storms in the church life soon pass away. Ibig sabihin, kapag may dumating na bagyo sa buhay natin, hindi yan magtatagal. But you should know that because of your opinion, that opinion brings you a super typhoon. Gusto mo bang magkaroon ng super typhoon sa buhay mo, sa simbahan mo, sa pag-aaral mo, sa negosyo mo? Refrain from your opinion. Ask God's will to your life. Let the will of God happen. Let the will of God be done to your life. All the disorder in the church, all the disorder in your family, all the disorder in your workplace, all the disorder in your business are the same in principle. They are caused by people who seek for position but are not useful because of their opinion. Itong mga taong itong mga opinion ang siyang dahilan bakit meron tinatawag na trouble, bakit meron tinatawag na disorder. An opinionated person mostly is unable to control. Ang hirap kayang kontrolin ng mga taong maprinsipyo. They are the person mostly, those opinionated person mostly, they are unable to control their opinion. Kahit sila mismo, hindi nila kayang kontrolin yung kanilang opinion. Talagang sasabihin at sasabihin nila yan. At ang masama pa nito, ini-insist nila yung opinion nila. An opinionated person mostly are not suitable for the Lord's work. Yan ang dahilan bakit hindi tayo magamit ng ating Panginoon. Kapag masyado tayo maraming opinion, for sure the Lord will not use us. And it will not be fitted for the Lord's opinion work. Natin, it always damages the ministry of God. Actually, our disposition is ourself. Every human being has this what we call disposition, has this self. Nasa ating yan. At tayo yan. Our disposition makes it hard for us to release our spirit. Because of us, because of ourself, because of our disposition, the spirit is hard up, nahihirapan na lumabas, nahihirapan na kumilos sa atin. Now, if we do not learn the lesson of breaking ourselves, we will always have a difficult time in our Christian journey, in the church life, in our business, in our workplace, at maging sa mga mag-aaral. May God bless us to break ourselves so that we may be useful by the Lord effectively sa ministry niya, effective tayong maging mag-aaral, effective tayo na isang negosyante, effective tayo na husband or wife, effective tayo sa lahat ng area if we learn to break ourselves. Nawa ang opinion natin ay mawala sa atin. Learn to break ourselves, our disposition. Let God be God. Learn to submit to the Lord's will and not by your opinion.